Good morning, everyone. Today I am going to discuss about money and its functions. I have already discussed what is money. Money may be defined as anything which is generally accepted by the people in exchange of goods and services or in repayment of debt. Or according to Walker, money is what money does. Money has made economic life systematic and organized one by performing various functions. Let us discuss functions of money. Functions of money can be classified into two, primary functions and secondary functions, according to its nature. Under primary, there are two functions, medium of exchange and measure of value. Whereas in the case of secondary functions, there are two functions, standard of deferred payment and store of value. Generally, money is a matter of functions four, such as a medium, a measure, a standard, and a store. Medium of exchange and measure of value are of prime importance in the society. These functions will go through the everyone in the society, irrespective of rich and poor. Let us discuss medium of exchange function of money. This is a central function of money. For performing this function, money should have a general acceptability. Money as a medium of exchange removes the difficulty of double coincidence of wants. Money facilitates sales and purchase independent of each other. With the help of money, exchange became easy one. Second function is measure of value. Money serves as a unit of account. We can express the value of a commodity in terms of money. It is called price. By knowing the prices of various commodities, it is easy to calculate exchange ratios between them. Here we have completed the primary functions of money, which means primary functions of money, medium of exchange first, here as a medium. Second case is measure of value, means as a unit of account. That's all. Next part is secondary functions of money. Here there are two functions, standard of deferred payments and store of value function. These are called secondary functions. These functions are derived from primary functions. Let us discuss standard of deferred payment function of money. With the help of money, future payment became easy. Money has certain qualities such as general acceptability, stability, and durability. So we can borrow money and repay money in future. Debts are usually expressed in terms of money. Such a way, money connects the value of today with those of the future. Next function, store of value. Store of value function means money can be stored for use in future. Holding money equivalent to keeping a reserve of liquid assets, because it can be easily converted into things. People therefore normally wish to keep a part of their wealth in the form of money, because savings in terms of goods is very difficult one. Now we can make a conclusion about the functions of money. There are four functions of money. Medium of exchange, that is the first one. Second one, measure of value. And third one is standard of deferred payment. And fourth one is store of value. Medium of exchange function means money as a medium. Second one is measure of value, means it serves unit of account. Third, standard of deferred payment. It serves as a future payment. And fourth one is store of value, which means holding value. Here, instead of keeping things, we can keep money. That is more convenient to all. That's all about functions of money. Thank you.